Welcome,
Aline.
Hello.
Hi. And Susanna. So welcome if you're already watching through the live. If you can come through the Zoom link, I recommend, because it's easier to work if you're watching live anyway. Let's see, we'll take a couple of minutes to see who else is dropping in. So if you're already here in the room, then just find a comfortable seated position so you can already try to arrive here and take a moment to just sink into the mat, sitting up straight. And in the meantime, we'll see and wait a little bit longer for people to arrive. Ah, great. Jessica is also there. Good. Happy that it worked. So I hope you all had a good sleep this night. And you were able to find your way through also the closing meditation and sharings last night. I did it in the morning because I'm in the Netherlands. So probably, Pauline, you're in Germany, right? So yeah, so we are in the same time zone.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you manage to dive into it this morning or?
I tried.
Yeah.
I managed to do most of it.
Oh, good. Wonderful. Yeah, it's all flowing in time and we all will find how it fits into the schedules and just keep tuning in with yourself as well, like what you need at what time. I think we'll just start today's class for now. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, we're going to work through Zoom and through Facebook Live. And I'll just introduce first what this class is going to be about, because I've been introducing myself yesterday in the circle, but also on the video, as having a background and my foundation in the Bikram yoga. So that's why I'd like to share today with you this sequence. And before we will just also take some time to sink in meditation, and then I'll explain a little more about it so you know what's going on in the class. Oh, my life is just falling over. So I'll just take a moment here. Okay. Good morning, Andrew. I just see you moving in. If you have the chance to come through the Zoom, please do, because it's easier to interact. And I can see you and I can give corrections and instructions and all those kinds of things, like in a normal yoga class. So that's why I prefer the Zoom. If you're able to be here live now, then I try to come in. So, and because we have the screens horizontally, I have to be creative, because usually I would be standing up in poses, but as you see, you can't see my head right now. So I will be on my knees in some poses, and then you guys will just be standing up, and it doesn't matter to me if I can't see your head. It's more important that you will be able to do the pose like it's meant to instead of on the knees. So just clarifying this. And then we'll start here on the meditation cushion, or just seated on your knees, it doesn't really matter. Most important here is that you have a straight spine. So for not everyone, it's possible to sit with the knees or the legs crossed. If this is painful or the knees stay up like this, then the lower spine starts rounding. So then I would recommend to sit on the knees, Japanese style, so you can keep a straight spine. Or you can also, if it's still not possible for you, you can also sit like this. So these are the modifications for just having a straight spine. It's really not that important to have the legs crossed like yogis do. So if it's comfortable for you, then try to sit with the knees lower than the hips so that the spine can be straight. And then we'll take a moment just to close the eyes and tap in, tune in to ourselves, and take a moment here to arrive on the mat and leave everything outside of your mat, of your room, that already happened today. And just notice the breath where it is right now without changing it. Relax your shoulders and relax your jaw. And bring your attention to your sit bones for a moment. Notice if you can feel them on your bolster, on your cushion, or on the mat, or maybe on your heels if you sit on your knees. And we'll take three deep breaths in through the nose and out of the mouth. Inhale. Exhale, let go of any tension. Inhale, expand your ribcage. Exhale, let go. One more, inhale. And exhale, release. Come back to a neutral breath. And lengthen the spine by picking up the lower back ribs. Draw navel in, lift your heart, elongate your neck, the back of your neck, crown of the head up to the sky. Feel your knees, sit bone touching the mat, touching the earth, really rooting down in the earth. Just like a plant, just like a tree. Notice your breath. Welcome, Liz. And rising up through the spine, the Sushumna, clear and open channel for the love and light of Source, up to the crown of the head, and reaching up to the sky, connecting to Father Sky, connecting to Mother Earth. Opening up the channel of love that you are. Expanding through the heart space on every exhale. Expanding through the heart space on every inhale. And then let all the love and light of the universe drop into the crown of your head, down through all the chakras, pouring out the root chakra into the earth, reaching out to the center of the earth, through the love of Pachamama. Pulling back up all the love of Mother Earth in through the root and back into the heart. So you're connecting all this light and love of the universe to all the love and light of the earth in the center of your being. You can bring your hands together in front of your chest, in front of your heart. And take a moment here to remind yourself of your intention. And then we'll start with three ohms. So first inhale to exhale. And inhale for ohm. Oh. Release your hands down to your knees. Open your eyes with a soft gaze. Welcome back. Everyone has arrived. So as I said at the very beginning of this class, I'd like to take you through a Bikram yoga class where we do all postures just once. Usually the sequence, all poses are done twice. It's a Hatha yoga sequence. So basically we're just doing Hatha yoga. I'm curious to know if anyone is familiar with Bikram yoga. Have you done a class? Anytime, you can just raise your hand. Yes, Pauline, and also Susanna. Elizabeth also, Liz, yeah, great. So we have all pros going on here. Awesome, so you kind of know what's going on then. And usually we use a mirror. So the extra challenge today will be having no mirror, although it can also be confronting for a lot of people, but it's meant to be helpful because then you can see what you're actually doing and if your shoulders are straight or one shoulder is dropping down and all that. But in today's class, we will just focus on really feeling inside the body, if you can notice those little differences inside yourself. I will do the poses with you, and although you can watch me and see what the pose is about, if you don't need to and you can just listen, then I would recommend to focus on one point in front of you and really tap into your own body. If this is your first time doing this kind of sequence, it can be kind of or quite overwhelming because I'll be talking a lot through the poses. So it's very much about listening to all the little cues in the sequence. And later on in this training, I will also do a class on Hatha yoga cueing and how to build up these cues if you want to really guide people through yoga verbally instead of showing the poses yourself. So let it just wash over you if this is your first time or if you feel like it's too much information. Just pick up what you will pick up and know that you're supported and guided anyway, and that all that will happen is meant to happen. So we start with a breathing exercise, and you can come all to standing on your feet. Because my head is not visible when I'm standing, I will be on my knees. But you can come all to standing and bring your feet together, big toes touch. And we build all poses up from the floor in the standing series. And we start with the breathing. For the breathing exercise, if you haven't done it before, you can watch a couple of times what's happening. And we start first with contracting the thighs, the butt cheeks. So you have a strong, stable standing position. And interlace your fingers under your chin, knuckles against the chin, and your thumbs are crossed against your throat. You relax your shoulders. We will breathe in through the nose and out of the mouth. So remember, if this is your first time, just watch me for a couple of breaths before you join in. So on the inhale, bring the elbows wide and up. Draw your navel in, fill up your lungs from the top to the bottom. And exhale, chin up, mouth open. Make a ha sound out of the throat, elbows away from the chest. You look up to the ceiling. Inhale, slowly bring your chin down parallel to the floor. Elbows widen up, spread your ribcage. Exhale, open your mouth. Press the elbows away from your chest. They don't need to touch, but they stay in line with your shoulders. Inhale, slow movements, slow breathing. So take your time. Control your breath and your movement. Exhale, open your mouth. Ha sound so you can control the breath slowly out of the mouth. Inhale, knuckles against the chin. Chin resists, elbows wide and up. Draw your navel in, feel stretch in your fingers. Exhale, knuckles against the chin. Chin resists, wrists together, elbows away from the chest. Inhale. Keep going. Slowly bring your chin parallel to the floor, elbows wide and up. Look forward, one point in front of you. Exhale. Knuckles against the chin. Chin resist. Elbows away from the chest. So elbows move forward. That's it. Inhale. Slow movement. Slow breath. Keep your spine long. Press your heels into the floor. Exhale. Take your time. Slowly bring your chin up and the elbows forward. Look up towards the ceiling. Inhale for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold it. And exhale for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And inhale, elbows wide enough. Look forward. Keep your chin down. Draw the navel in. Exhale, now bring the chin up. Elbows away from the chest. Look up. You're bending your head backwards, your neck backwards. Inhale, slowly bring your chin back down. Elbows wide enough. So look forward. That's it, nice. Exhale, open your mouth. We're warming up the body from inside out. Keep your spine long. And inhale, two more. Elbows wide enough. Press your heels into the floor, look forward. Exhale, bring your chin up. Squeeze your butt cheeks, support your lower spine. Elbows away from the chest. Inhale for one more last breath of the day. Maybe your deepest breath to take an extra sip of air. Elbows wide and up, look forward. Find your focus point. Exhale, slowly press all the air out of the lungs. Elbows away from the chest, empty the lungs completely, draw your navel in, change. And slowly bring the arms next to your body. Relax your shoulders. From now on, we breathe in and out through the nose. Adho Chandrasana, half moon pose, and Padmasasana, hands to feet pose. So you're standing on your feet, big toes together, strong legs. Bring your hand palms out, arms sideways overhead, and interlace your fingers, release your index fingers, and cross your thumbs. So, the abyssal grip, that's it. Then inhale, lift up, chest away from the hips, lengthen. Exhale, slowly move your body to the right. Come back to the center and stretch to the left. So we're stretching the sides of the ribcage. Take it easy, it's early in the morning, so you're just waking up the spine. Stretching the skin at the sides of your body, over your hips, your armpits. Keep lengthening every time you move through the center line. Then come back to the center. Squeeze your inner thighs together. Inhale, lift your chest, arms, hands up, and slowly move your body in a straight line to the right. Without moving the elbows, without moving the knees, so keep your arms and legs straight. Deep stretch on the entire left side of your body. Press your left heel into the floor and squeeze your hands closer together, pressing the fingers into the hands. And bring your right shoulder forward and your left hip forward to bring hips and shoulders parallel to the front of your mat, like your body is in between two glass plates. And inhale, lift your left ribcage up and stretch your arms out over and eventually down to the right, bring your hips to the left. Change, move back to the center. Come up straight, then the other side. Squeeze your legs together. Inhale, lift your chest, arms, legs up, lengthen, and slowly move your body in a straight line to the left without moving the elbows, without moving the knees, so keep your arms and legs straight. Feel skin stretching sensation, deep stretching sensation on the right side of your body. And bring the left shoulder forward, right hip forward. So hips and shoulders are parallel to the front of the mat, like your body is in between two glass plates. Keep your focus, keep breathing. Squeeze the hand palms together. Anchor the left heel into the floor, right heel into the floor. Then inhale, lift your right ribcage up and stretch your arms out, over, and eventually down to the left, hips to the right. And come back to the center. And we go to the first back bend. And lift your chin up and relax your neck back. Squeeze your butt cheeks, squeeze your thighs, strong foundation. And inhale, lift your chest, arms, hands up, reach up, and slowly start to bend back. Send your hips forwards, lift from your chest and upper back, then from your middle back, and eventually from your lower back. Look back, go back, lift from the chest, move your arms closer to your ears, change, and then slowly move back to your center. Parasasana, hands to feet pose. Inhale, reach up, lengthen, and come forward from the hips to the straight spine. If you can't go any further with straight spine, and bend your knees to keep your spine straight and come all the way down, hands are on the floor. And bend your knees right and left, right, left, to create some space at the back of your legs this morning. Especially in the morning, you might feel a lot stiffer in your legs, your lower back. Relax your neck. Drop the head down. Look at your toes, your ankles. You can bend both knees at the same time if you like. So really take some time here. It's a warming up pose. Just opening up the muscles. Then come to a stop and bend your knees as much as you need to bring your stomach on your thighs. No air or light between stomach and thighs. Elbows behind your calf muscles, pinkies side by side. Fingers under the heels. And lift the hips up, roll forward to the balls of the feet. Keep breathing through your nose. So four steps, bring the elbows behind your calf muscles. Fingers under the heels. Lift the hips up. And stretch your chest, head closer down to the floor. Keep breathing, pull on the heels and pull your shoulders away from your ears. And change, bring your hands back next to your head. Stretch forward, bend your knees to slowly come back up with a straight spine. All the way up and then slowly float your arms back by our sides. Next pose is Utkatasana chair pose. So you step your right foot to the right, your hip distance. So that's under the hip bones, not so much the outsides of the hips, but on the center of your hips. Bring the big toes in, so the insides of the feet are parallel to each other. Stretch your arms forward. Squeeze the fingers together, thumbs and index fingers, to begin with strong arms. Inhale, lift your chest. Bend your knees and sit down way behind you. Like there's a chair standing behind you. Weight is in your heels. And press your toes into the floor as well. Pull the shoulders back, lift the chest. So you create an arch in the lower back, lifting the chest up. Maybe you can sit down a little lower. Change, come back up. Second part here, come on high up on the toes. Tippy toes, the tops of the feet forward, heels on top of the toes. Inhale, lift your chest. Bend your knees to slowly come down with a straight spine. So high on the tippy toes, lift the heels up, lift the knees up and forward. Keep your spine straight. Draw the navel in to keep your abdominals contracted. And press the floor weight to come back up. Third part and slowest part, come on the balls of your feet and squeeze your thighs together. One big thigh. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, bend your knees and slowly come down. Keep your spine parallel to the wall behind you. Come down as low as you can with a straight spine. So if you notice your spine is leaning forward, stay up a little higher. Squeeze your knees together. Inhale. And on your exhale, come slowly, 10 counts in your head, back up with control. Heels down, feet together, arms by your sides. Find your breath in and out through your nose. And focus one point in front of you. And feel your feet on the mat. Eagle pose, arms overhead, hand palms together. Bring your right arm under your left, cross at your elbows, wrists, thumbs are in front of the nose. If you can still see me, right arm under the left. That's it. You cross at your elbows, right arm under the left. Down at your wrist, thumbs are in front of the nose. That's it, good. And inhale, lift your chest. Bend your knees and sit down way behind you. Bring the weight into the left foot. Lift your right leg up over the left. Squeeze your thighs and bring your toes behind your heel. Bring your toes down behind the heel so no arrow line between the heel and the top of your right foot. Lift your chest, sit down lower. Pull your right hip back so two hips move in one line. Lift your chest again, pull the elbows down. And maybe sit one more lower. Change. Arms overhead, hand palm stretch. Think what is right, what is left, and bring left arm under the right. Cross at the elbow, so left arm under the right, then at the wrists, thumbs are in front of the nose. So demonstrate this one again. Left under the right, hands together. Lift the chest, bend your knees, sit down low. Bring the weight into the right foot. Left leg over the right. Squeeze your thighs together. Toes behind your heel. Let them slide down towards your heel. Lift your chest up. Bring the left hip back so your knees move to the left. And sit down a little lower. So really pull your hips back to the wall behind you. Then lift the chest. Creating an arch in your lower back. Pull your elbows down, lift your chest up. Change. Arms overhead and palm stretch. And arms float back down to your side. I'm just going to correct the camera a little bit for the standing poses. So again, find your breath. In and out through the nose, every time the heart rate goes up, you help with your breath to bring it back down. We'll start balancing on the left leg. Welcome to all the pets that are joining us today. I see some dogs and cats. Press your left foot into the floor, contract your left thigh muscle. Draw your navel in, contract your butt cheek, and then lift your right leg up. It's a strong, strong foundation on the left leg. Before you lift your right leg up. So you have the power to balance, the strength to balance. The ankle below the knee, flex at the ankle, toes up to the ceiling. This is already a lot of practice, so you can stay here or inhale and lift your chest and round over your bent leg, reach your hands towards your foot. If this is enough, you can stay here while this is happening, straightening the leg, and strengthening the leg, rounding your spine. If you have enough space in your spine today, then interlace the fingers under the ball of the foot. Keep your right thigh parallel to the floor and your ankle below your knee. If you have the grip, standing leg is still straight and strong, only then kick your right heel forward. Right leg parallel to the floor, no higher, no lower. If your knee is still bent here, then keep your heel in line with your right hip. Wherever you are, draw the navel in to support your lower spine. Look one point in front of you, both legs straight, and bend your elbows down next to your calf muscle. Change. Slowly reverse back out of your pose, step by step. Other side. Right foot into the floor, contract your right thigh muscle. Lift your left leg up. Thigh parallel to the floor, ankle below your knee, flex toes up, flex at your ankle. Find again the strength in your right leg. So that's where the pose begins. You can stay here or go forward, inhale, lift your chest. Slowly round down over your bent leg, reach your hands towards your foot. You have enough space, interlace the fingers under the ball of the foot. Press your heel down. To feel stretch in your wrists, elbows, and shoulders. You have the grip, standing leg is still straight and strong, then only kick your heel forward. Left leg parallel to the floor, no higher, no lower. Whatever you add, brought a navel in to support your lower spine. Look forward, one point of focus. Both legs are straight and bend your elbows down next to your back muscle. And then slowly reverse back out of the pose step by step. Straightening the spine, foot back down. Breathe through the nose. Standing bow, pulling pose. Again, left foot into the floor. Strong left leg, lift your left arm up, hand palm forward. Bring the right elbow close to your body, hand palm up. Now reach your right arm back as far as you can. Bend your right knee and grab your right foot on the inside. All five fingers are at your ankle. Now bring the knees next to each other so two hips are in one line. And first inhale, lift the left side of your body up, reach up, right knee down, and then kick your foot back on up into your hands. And first feel the back bend, take your time. If you can't kick back any further, then look over the fingertips. Reach forward, bring the left shoulder towards your chin. Lift your chest, keep your standing leg strong and straight. Left shoulder reaches forward, right shoulder back, two shoulders move away from each other. Keep reaching, you can balance here forever. Kick back, reach forward. Kick your foot back and up through your hands, look over the fingertips, lift your chest, and slowly come back up. Right foot down, left arm by your side. Deep inhale through the nose, deep exhale through your nose. Reach your right arm up, hand palm forward, press your right foot into the floor. The whole left side of the body, or right side of the body is long. Left elbow close to the body, reach your left arm back. Thumb is on the top. Bend your left knee and grab your foot on the inside. Bring your knees together. Two hips are next to each other. Notice if you can feel this. And inhale, reach up, lengthen. Exhale, kick your foot back and up into your hands. First, feel your back bend. You can't kick back any further. Then reach your right arm forward. Look over the fingertips. Bring your right shoulder close to the nose, close to your chin. Reach forward, kick back. Keep your standing legs straight and strong. Reach right shoulder forward, reach left shoulder back. Two shoulders move away from each other. Keep reaching, keep kicking. You can balance here forever. Chin away from your chest. Keep the back bent. Reach forward, kick back. And slowly reverse back out of your pose. Feet back together, arms by your side. Come to the back of the mat. Virtulandasana balancing stick. Bring your feet together. Big toe stitch. Bring your arms overhead, interlace your fingers, release your index fingers and cross your thumbs. Straight arms next to your face. Bring right foot forward, left toes off the mat, balance. This is where the pose begins. And lift the back of your lower ribs up, back ribs, lower back ribs. Draw the navel in, keep that feeling. Inhale, stretch up, and slowly move your body out, over and forward. Look underneath the pinky fingers, point your toes back. Draw your navel in, keep your standing leg strong. Reach forward, point back. Change and slowly step back on your mat. Feet together, left foot forward. Right toes off the mat, balance. Lift the lower back ribs up, draw the navel in, lift your chest, inhale, stretch up. And slowly move your body down and forward. Point your toes back, reach forward, point back. Draw your navel in, your capital letter T from the side. Reach forward, point back. And slowly step on your mat back. Float your arms down by your side. Breathe in and out through the nose. So let the pose already be in the past and come back by your breath to be back in the now. And then take a quarter turn, on your mat. So you can use the length of your mat for separate leg stretching poses. Feet together. We stand on the left side of the mat, so you can step out to the right. Bring your arms overhead, hand palm stretch. Take a big step, right foot out to the right, arms parallel to the floor. That's it, wide step. Bring the big toes inwards. Dogs and cats love to do yoga. So squeeze your inner thighs together. Inhale, lift your chest and come forward from the hips. Chin away from your chest, look forward so you can lengthen the neck in line with the spine. If you can't go any further, then reach your hands to grab the sides of the feet, the heels. Bend your knees if you have a sensitive lower back or if you can't reach your heels. And then roll the weight forward to the toes, lift your hips up. Pull your shoulders away from the ears. Keep breathing. So we're lengthening the spine and creating a stretch from the heels to the hips, hips to the neck. So draw the navel in, stretch your chest and forehead down to the floor. Eventually your forehead will touch the floor. Lift your hips up. Change, stretch your arms out to the side and slowly move back up. Straight spine. And step your feet together, arms overhead. Arms by your side. Trikonasana triangle pose. Arms overhead, hand palms stretch. Big step, right foot out to the right. Arms parallel to the floor. So here we bring the hips forward, tailbone down. So you're ready to create a stretch on the top of the thighs. Turn on your right heel, toes to the right, to the front of the mat. Inhale, lift your chest, bend your right knee, sit down low. Thigh parallel to the floor and turn your left hip inwards. Hands to the side. On your next exhale, move your body to the right. Right arm inside, right knee, left arm up towards the ceiling. Turn your chin to the left, look up at your left thumb. Use your right arm to press your right knee back and your right hip forward. Turn your left ribcage back, look up. Press the outside of the left foot into the floor, straight line, left leg, left ribcage, reach up and change. Come back to your center. Straighten the right leg, turn the toes forward. First, bring the hips forward, tailbone down to create a stretch on the top of the thighs. Turn the left heel toes to the back of your mat. Inhale, lift your chest, bend your left knee, sit down low, thigh parallel to the floor. That's it. Right hip inwards. Turn your hands to the side. On your exhale, move your left arm to the left, right arm up. Press your left arm on the inside of the left knee. Chin to the right, look up. Straight line, right leg, right rib cage. Press left arm against left knee, bring left hip forward. Right rib cage back. Look up. Squeeze your inner thighs, strong foundation. Change, come back to your center, straighten the left leg, turn the toes forward, and step your feet together, arms overhead, arms by your side. Breathe through the nose, find your focus. From now on, we'll bring the heart rate down in the next couple of poses until we go down to the floor series. Arms overhead, hands together, cross your thumbs. Only, so straight fingers. Big step, right foot out to the right. On your inhale, lift your arms and toes up and turn to the right. Right toes straight in front of you, left toes forward and to the sides in a 45 degree angle. So if the left toes are standing 90 degrees, bring them forward so you can bring the left hip forward. Two hips are in line with the top of the mat. And inhale, reach your fingers away from your right big toe up to the ceiling. Bring your chin down and slowly start to round down. As your arms catch the back of your head, fingers come in front of your right toes into the mat, foreheads to your left knee. Bend your left knee if you need to. And pull your right hip back, left hip forward. Press your back heel into the floor. And squeeze your inner thighs towards each other to keep balance. Chain straighten the front leg and slowly round back up. Use your abdominals. Neck and head come up last. Look forward. Turn on your heels to the side. And turn on your heels one more to the left. So now the left foot is forward. Right foot to the side. So you can bring your right hip forward. Again, make sure your right foot is not a 90 degree angle, but 45 degrees, so more forward, so you can bring your right hip forward. Inhale, lift your fingers away from your left big toe, chin to the chest, and slowly start rounding down. Take your time, go as slow as you need to. Bring your forehead to your knee, fingers in front of the toes into the mat. Bend your left knee if you need to. Left hip back, right hip forward. Press back heel into the mat. And squeeze your inner thighs towards each other to keep your balance. Chain, straighten the left leg and slowly round back up. Neck and head come up last. Take a look in front of you to arrive here. And then turn back to the side. Step your feet together, arms by your side. Beautiful. Last standing pose. Tree pose. So you come to the center of your mat. You can turn back to the front if you want to. That doesn't really matter, I think. Okay. Then bring your feet together, big toe stretch. Bring your left foot into the floor. Contract the left thigh muscle and lift your right knee up. You can use both hands to lift the knee up higher than the hips. Point your toes and grab your left foot underhand, or right foot with the left hand underhand grip. Knee goes to the right and down. If your knee is sensitive, you can keep holding it here with the right hand. So knee can go down all the way, right hand in front of the chest. Stretch the right knee down, bring right hip forward. So you create a deep stretch in the hip and the thigh. Pull shoulders down, lengthen the neck. And look one point in front of you. Concentrate, meditate. Change, right knee up, right foot down. Press right foot into the floor, contract your right thigh muscle, butt cheek, and then lift your left knee up. You can use both hands, so bring the knee up higher than your hips. Point your toes, grab the foot right hand, underhand grip. Knee goes to the left and down. You can hold your knee if you need to. You can go all the way down, left hand in front of the chest. So yeah, if you hold the foot in the front, your shoulder is closing here. So that's why you hold the foot and the hand grip, opening up the shoulder. That's it. Yes, now you got it. Pull the shoulders down, lengthen the neck. Look forward. Change, left knee up, left foot down. And then turn around, lie down on your mat for Savasana. Legs close to each other, feet will open naturally to the sides. Arms next to your body and hand palms up. Keep your eyes open to stay present. And look one point in front of you on the ceiling. Maybe you need to adjust your camera so I can still see you on the floor, but you can also do it, yeah, later. Oh, the puppy likes it that you're lying down. So just focus on your breathing. Savasana, corpse pose, irrigation pose. So by lying down like this with the legs together and the arms close to your body, you give your heart the chance or to pump everything the blood round in your body with the least amount of effort. So we will gain the most amount of energy for the floor series. You can just completely relax. Relax your hips, your shoulders, let them sink into the mat. And just focus on the breath. Next pose is wind removing pose. First, broaden your shoulder blades on the mat. Press your left heel down into the mat, 3 points. Then bend your right knee up. Interlace the fingers on top of the knee and pull the knee to your right shoulder. Again, broaden your shoulders flat on the mat. Bring your chin down so you lengthen the back of your neck. Pull your shoulders down and away from your head. Change, bring your right leg down, press right heel into the floor, then bend your left knee. Interlace the fingers on top of the knee, pull the left knee to the left shoulder. Again, broaden the shoulders flat on the mat, also the right shoulder. And bring your chin down to the length in the back of the neck. Bring the left leg down, bend both knees to your chest, and grab opposite elbows on your knees. If you can't reach your elbows, then your wrists or forearms. Bring your chin down to the length of the back of the neck. Pull your shoulders down. So eventually your neck, spine, and tailbone are flat on the mat. Press your knees gently against your arms so you can uncoil your tailbone a little further to the floor. Change both legs down, arms next to your body, hand palms up, Savasana. Next pose will be a sit-up. If you have a sensitive lower back or neck today, you can skip the sit-up and just do the breathing with us and then turn onto your side and onto your belly. So for the sit-up, we bring the feet together, flex the ankles, toes towards your face. You can look up, look at your feet if you're actually straight in line. The feet are straight in line with your hips. Bring your arms overhead, press your thumbs. Inhale, squeeze your inner thighs, draw the navel in, round your spine, sit up, exhale, double exhale. So this breathing will come back a couple of times. You can turn around and lie down on your belly. For Cobra, the first spine strengthening pose. Bring the hands next to your rib cage. Fingers are in line with the tops of the shoulders, elbows up to the ceiling. Squeeze the legs together. Squeeze your arms close to your rib cage. Then inhale through your nose down to your toes. And peel your upper body slowly up the mat. Pull the elbows towards the hips. Look up, chin up. Squeeze your legs together. 100% back strength here, 10% in the hands. Lift your chest up, Lift your chin up, look up, keep breathing. And then slowly lower down, look to the right, arms by your side, relax. On the inhale, your back rises, and on the exhale, your back falls. Salabhasana, bring your chin on the mat and turn your arms around. So the thumbs are on the outside, the arms are against the floor. You can still keep in the pose, just listen very carefully. I can't show you this pose and talk at the same time. So turn your toes under, lift your hips up and bring both arms underneath your body. So you lie on top of your elbows. That's it, perfect. Then relax your left leg and straighten the right leg. And inhale, lift your right leg up and reach your toes back. So you use your back strength to lift your leg up. Reach your toes back, press your hands against the floor. Change, bring your right leg down. And relax your right leg, straighten the left leg. And inhale, lift your left leg up. And reach your toes back, press your hands against the floor. That's it. Change left leg down. Then we go to the part with two legs. So bring your mouth on the mat or on the towel, like you're kissing your mat. And reach your arms closer to your knees. And keep your mouth on the mat. This is a pose without looking anywhere. Really tuning into your body. And squeeze your legs together. Inhale through the nose, down to your toes. And lift both legs up. Press your hands against the floor. That's it. Squeeze the legs together. Lift your legs up. Reach your toes back. That's it, Jessica. Lift your legs up. Keep breathing through the nose. Change and keep your mouth on the towel. Slowly release your legs down. Release your arms underneath your body. Look to the left. Arms by your side. So especially the first time, all these new poses, if you haven't done it before, it can be quite intense or overwhelming, but as you do it more often, you will journey deeper and deeper through the poses. Your body will remember, knows what's happening, and that's when the magic starts to happen. So next pose, bring your arms out to the side, chin on the mat. If you don't have enough room where you are, then bring the arms more back and just focus very much on the back bend in this pose. Squeeze your legs together. Inhale through your nose, down through your toes. Exhale, lift your chest, arms, legs off the mat. And think about a back bend away from the earth. Squeeze your legs together. Lift your chest up. Lift your chin up. Look up. Reach your hands to the sides of your room. Lift your chest up one more. Look up, go up. And slowly lower down. Look to the right. Arms by your side. And relax. Breathe through the nose. Relax your hands, relax your feet. Next is bow pose, from your chin on the mat. Bend your knees and grab your feet from the outside, all five fingers between your toes and your ankles. And bring your knees closer together, heels as well. So the heels are hip distance, knees are hip distance. And relax your shoulders. Inhale, bring your hip bones down to the mat and kick your feet back into your hands. First, feel your back bend. Then balance on the soft part of your belly and look up, chin up. Relax shoulders towards each other. Kick your feet into your hands. Strength comes from the kick of your legs. Look up, kick back, look up, kick back. And change, slowly release. Come down to the mat, look to the left. Arms by your side. And press your hands next to your shoulders into the mat and slowly push yourself up to hands and knees. And come to the top of your mat on your hands and knees, knees together, heels wider than your hips. Your toes point straight behind you. And slowly bring your hips in between your heels. If you feel pressure or pain in the knees, then support yourself on the floor, hands on the floor, and stay there. This is your pose. Enough is happening here for you. If you can go back and the knees, ankles are fine, you can go further, hands on the feet, fingers forwards. Lift your chest, chin to the chest, and slowly come back onto the elbows. So always stay in part of the pose where your body is still comfortable. If you can go all the way back, the shoulder blades back of the head, knees are still on the mat, then grab your elbows overhead and pull the shoulders down towards the hips. So if this is too much and the knees start to come off the mat, then come one step back onto your elbows. Breathe towards the lower belly, wherever you are, and press your toes, ankles, and knees towards the floor. Change. Bring your hands on the feet, fingers forward, press your elbows into the mat, and slowly lift your chest up, then your neck and head. Turn around, lie down on your back, Savasana. Arms by your side, hand palms up, and relax. Adho Mukha Asana, half tortoise pose, feet together, flex your toes, arms overhead, crush your thumbs. Inhale, squeeze your thighs, sit up, round your spine, double exhale. And turn around, come to the back of the mat and sit on your knees. If you can't sit on your knees, you can also stand on the knees here. But there's always modifications, just ask if you have any questions later on. Bring the arms overhead, hand palms stretched, cross only your thumbs, straight arms next to your face. And inhale, lift your chest up, reach up, and slowly come forward with a straight spine. You can lift your hips off the heels to keep the spine straight. Pinkies on the mat, maybe your forehead. Chin away from the chest, so maybe the nose can touch the mat. So you look down at the mat instead of your knees, so you can lengthen your neck. And line with your spine. On each inhale, reach your arms forward to lengthen. On each exhale, pull your hips back to your heels. And inhale, squeeze your knees together, reach your arms out and forward, slowly come back up. Use your abdominals for a straight spine all the way up. Bring your arms back by your sides. Turn around, lie down on your back. Savasana. So after every action, a relaxation. To learn our bodies again how to relax, to regenerate, and also to keep safe in the poses, building every pose separately in Hatha Yoga. Camel pose, feet together, flex your toes, arms overhead, cross your thumbs. Inhale, squeeze your thighs, sit up, round your spine, double exhale. And turn around and come to stand on your knees. Knees are hip distance. So again, below the hip bones, instead of the sides of the hips. So it might be closer together than you think. And bring your hands to your lower back, fingers down, pinkies touch. Inhale, lift your chest, chin up, and slowly start to move back. Take your time. If this is enough for you, you can stay here. If you can grab your heels, go ahead. Make sure your hips stay on top of your knees. So reach one hand to one heel, then the other hand to the other heel. If you can't, just keep supporting yourself in your lower back. So always take the time that your body needs to open up. Breathe through your nose. Send your hips forward, lift from your chest. So come out of the pose, one hand in the lower back, then the other one, straighten your spine. Wow, all camels here in the room. Straighten spine, hips down, and turn around. Lie back on your back, relax in Savasana. So yeah, usually it just depends on how much yoga you've done, if you're able to do a camel, but also on your anatomy. So it's not possible for everyone. Rabbit pose, feet together, flex your toes, arms overhead, press your thumbs. Inhale, squeeze your thighs, sit up. Double exhale, reach for your toes. Turn around and come to sit on your knees. Heels are together, hips on your heels. Bring your hands on your lower back like you did in camel. That's how you grab your hips. Inhale, lift your chest. Chin to the chest, slowly round down. As your elbows start to bend, then bring your hips up. Forehead against the knees. Front of the head is on the mat. Shoulders away from the ears. So this is also a pose where you can't look around, but you're really turning inwards. Listen to the dialogue. Lift your hips up, roll forward. Shoulders away from the ears, press the fingers into the heels and your arms against your thighs. Change. And slowly round back up. Yeah. Good. And turn around, lie down on your back and relax. Yeah. Savasana. Seated head to knee pose, feet together, flex your toes, arms overhead, brush your thumbs. Inhale, squeeze your inner thighs, sit up, round your spine. Double exhale. And turn on your mat and bring your right heel to the right corner of the mat and bend your left knee, foot on the inside of the right thigh. 90 degree angle between both thighs. Bring your arms overhead, interlace the fingers. Inhale, lift your chest up, turn to the right, and slowly round down, bring fingers over the ball of the foot, forehead against your knee, left shoulder down. Bend your knee if you need to grab the foot, and to bring the forehead to the knee. So it's not so much about the straight leg here, but more about the rounding spine. Change, come back up. Keep your arms overhead and switch your legs to left heel to left corner of the mat. Bend your right knee, foot on the inside of the left thigh. Inhale, lift your chest, turn to the left and slowly round down. Fingers over the ball of the foot. Forehead to knee. Bend your knee if you need to. Bring your right shoulder down. Just breathe through the nose. Keep both sit bones on the mat. Change, come back up, straighten both legs in front of you. If you can do the sit-up, then slowly lie down to the shoulder blades touch, and then immediately another sit-up. Grab the big toes with your index finger, middle finger, and thumb. So you have the peace grip, the index finger, middle finger, in between the big and second toe. You can bend your knees to straighten your spine if you need to. Pull the pinky toes towards you. And inhale, lift your chest, come forward from the hips. Elbows down or to the sides. Inhale, lift your chest, come forward from the hips. And imagine if you wouldn't have any arms, how would you bring your chest and your belly forward without arms? So really using the back muscles. Change and turn around, lie down on your back and relax in Savasana. Feet together, flex your toes, arms overhead, cross your thumbs. Inhale, squeeze your inner thighs, sit up, double exhale. And take a quarter turn on your mat for the last pose for this class. You bring the left knee in front of you and step your right foot over the left knee. If that's not possible, you can also straighten your left leg in front of you. Heel and knee are touching each other. Bring the right foot flat down on the floor. Inhale, lift your left arm up, lengthen. Turn to the right, press the left knee out to the side, grab the other knee or your mat, so you have something to hold on to. And reach your right arm all around your waist, hand on the outside of the left thigh. Inhale, lift your chest and turn, twist, look over the right shoulder. So you press your left arm against your right knee. Inhale, lift your chest. Turn, twist, look over the right shoulder. Slowly move back to your center. Switch your legs. So now the right knee is in front of you, left foot over the right knee. Heel and knee are touching. Left foot is flat on the mat. Inhale, lift your right arm up, lengthen. Turn to the left, bring it over the left knee, push the knee out to the side, grab the other knee or your mat and towel, or your mat. Inhale, turn your left arm all around your waist, hand on the outside of the left thigh. Lift your chest, pull shoulders down, turn, twist, look over the left shoulder. Inhale, lift your chest, pull the shoulders down, turn, twist, and look over your left shoulder. Slowly return back to your center. Turn around, lie down on your back, relax, and savasana. So in all these poses, we have been stretching the body, compressing the internal organs, massaging the organs. The CO2 has been released in the lungs. That's why we do the breathing exercise. So you empty out the lungs, clean out your lungs, and prevent yourself from getting a headache later on. Kapalbhati breathing. Bring the feet together, flex your toes, arms overhead, brush your thumbs, inhale, squeeze your thighs, sit up, double exhale. You turn around and sit on your knees, straight spine. Lift the chest up, shoulders relaxed, straight arms, hands on your thighs. And let your belly relax, so the belly can just hang, only pose in yoga where the belly is hanging. And then open your mouth, you're only pumping the belly. So when you draw your navel in, air comes out by itself. And begin. Three, two, one, change and release. Turn around, lie down on your back. In Savasana, your final Savasana, and you can cover yourself with a blanket for a moment so you keep warm and you're able to relax in this pose as long as you can, as it's very important in this pose so you can integrate everything you just did. You can close your eyes now and let your body sink into the mat. Take a moment here to thank yourself for showing up for this class. thank yourself for choosing this path, choosing these 2 weeks of diving deep into your own healing, into your own adventure, into your own life, expanding. Now relax your entire body into the mats. Relax your toes. Relax your ankles. Soften your calf muscles, your shins. Relax your knees, the back of the knees. Soften your thighs. Your hips, let them sink into the mat. Relax your fingers and your wrists. Relax your forearms, your elbows. Relax your arms. Relax your lower back, your middle back. Relax your upper back. Let your shoulders feel heavy, sink into the mat. Relax your neck, your jaw, relax your tongue. Soften all the little facial muscles and soften the spot in between your eyebrows. And let your eyes sink to the back of your head. Close your eyes one more time behind your eyes. Relax your hair at the crown of your head. Relax your entire body into the mat. Move your fingers, your toes. You can stretch yourself out if you like you're just waking up. And then turn yourself on your favorite side. You can stay there for a little bit with your eyes closed. And when you're ready, push yourself up with one hand to come to a seated position. And also there, you can stay with your eyes closed to keep your energy turned inwards. And again, feel your spine lengthening. Sit bones on your bolster on the floor, lengthening the spine up through the lower back, middle back, upper back. Back of the neck, crown of the head up to your ceiling, relax your shoulders. And we'll bring the hands together in front of the chest, in front of the heart. We'll close this yoga session with three more ohms. You can keep your eyes closed or a soft gaze in front of you. First, we inhale to exhale. Inhale. Exhale, release everything. Inhale for Om. Om. your head down towards your hands, to bow your head towards your heart, thanking yourself, thanking your ancestors, your guides, and thanking all of you for being here today. Namaste. So to continue, I have this very amazing meditation recording of Ram Dass, which is already posted below the Zoom post, but I'll post it again in the live video when I'm just shutting it down. I will post a link below that as well. And I highly recommend to do it right now after this practice and before you move into the next practice with John. Keep warm so you have a blanket on top of you, and drink some water before, use the bathroom, all of that, so you have the time for 30 minutes to dive into this meditation. It's pretty special. So I wish you a beautiful journey through that, and I'd like to hear about it later when we're connecting back in the workshop. So if you have any questions now, I will be here for a little bit, and you can unmute yourself or share anything in the comments. Let's see, yeah, we have a couple of minutes. So let me if you already found the link in the previous post. I can also try to share it here in the chat. And then you can also just close the Zoom and go on your own journey with this meditation. Thanks, Jessica. Wonderful. Yeah, so Hatha Yoga is basically this. And then there's also lots of other poses, of course. But it means that you take a break in between all the poses. I have a pet myself. Susanna, I have a cat, but she's out the entire day, but maybe in one of the other classes you will see her walk by. No, I really like this about the online teaching, that pets and sometimes babies or other family members are just joining, you know, it's all fine and all good. And it's also nice to get to know this part of, yeah, the participants. I'm not sure. I was thinking about that. If you don't have a Spotify account, if you can still do the meditation, I can see if I can find it on YouTube. I'll post the Spotify link here again. Okay. I'm just going to look for it on YouTube. I hope so, because there's probably more people not having the Spotify. Okay, we have to be patient. Yes, it's also on Spotify. Perfect. YouTube, I mean. Well, I'm just clicking on it now so you can also share this link. Oh, it's already starting. Maybe you hear the sound. Yeah, So take 5 minutes now to take your break before you do the meditation. So you all will also will be ready on time for the next yoga class. Okay, this is the YouTube link. I just posted it. Okay, cool. Really nice to get to know you all a little bit more. Yeah, and we'll talk later in the workshop, but we'll be also more sharing again. Have a beautiful morning, and I'll see you all at, what is it, your time? 9:30. That's still the morning. For me, it's the evening, so yeah. Okay. If you have any questions, leave them also in the live comments. I can still reply. Okay, good.